Stand. Lord, we just offer our worship up to you this morning. We love you so much, and you're so good and so worthy, and you are holy. And we just are excited to come and worship you this morning, God. Just pray that you'll bless this worship. In your name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Oh,
seen what you can do, O God of wonders. Your power has no end. The things you've done before in greater measure, you will do again. There's no prison wall you can't break through, no mountain you can't move, all things are possible. There's no broken body you can't raise, no soul that you can't save, all things are possible. The darkest city, oh God of revival. through, no mountain you can move, all things are possible. There's no broken body you can raise, no soul that you can save, all things are possible. Alone in my sorrow and dead in my sin, lost without hope and no place to begin. Your love made a way to let mercy come in, when death was arrested and my life began. Ash was redeemed, only beauty remains. My orphan heart was given a name. My mourning grew quiet, my feet rose to dance. When death was arrested, my life began. Oh, your grace. Chains, I'm a prisoner no more. My shame was a ransom he faithfully bore. He canceled my debt and he called me his friend. When death was arrested, my life began. Oh, your grace so free washes. It's your endless hanging on a criminal's cross. Darkness rejoiced as though heaven had lost. But then Jesus arose with our freedom in hand. That's when
the Spirit was moving over the water. Spirit, come move over us. Come rest on us. Come rest on us. As the Spirit was moving over the water, Spirit, come move over us. Come rest on us. Come rest on us. Come rest on us. Come rest on us.
Chapter 10, Peter was preaching to the Gentile church. He was preaching the gospel of Jesus Christ. And in his preaching, while he was still preaching, he was preaching Jesus. Someone say Jesus.
Jesus.
Love to worship Jesus. It says, while he was preaching, the Holy Spirit fell upon all those who heard the word. And those of the circumcision, that's the Jews, who believed were astonished, as many as came with Peter, because the gift of the Holy Spirit had been poured out on the Gentiles also. Gentiles did not have a covenant with God. Gentiles were separate from God. And so the Jewish people were amazed that God's Holy Spirit was poured out on them. It said, how did they know that the Holy Spirit was poured out? It says, for they heard them speak with tongues and magnify God. Then Peter answered, can anyone forbid water that these should be baptized who have received the Holy Spirit as we have? Then he commanded them to be baptized in Jesus' name. My daughter has a saying. She said, it's only weird if you make it weird. And a lot of people want to make the Holy Spirit weird. But it's not. The Holy Spirit's the power of God. And there is evidence when you're filled with the Holy Spirit. I don't get hung up on whether praying in tongues, but if you're baptized in the Spirit, you have that ability, whether you know it or not. And the other gifts of the Spirit should be flowing out of your life. There's words of knowledge. You hear it sometimes in here. God will give us the word of knowledge. You've seen it demonstrated. But the power of God should be on your life. I'm as feeble and small a guy as you'll meet. But when the Lord God gets on me, power comes on me. I get bold and courageous in God. And I do things. That's the Spirit. It's not by might or power. It's not because I'm a brave person. It's because God gets on me when you yield to the Spirit. So I want to challenge you. If you're not baptized in the Holy Spirit, we're singing a song about the Spirit falling. To be honest, if you're filled with the Holy Spirit, He's already in you. He's coming through you. Someone say amen.
Amen.
He should be coming through you. But if you're not filled with the Holy Spirit will fall on you today and fill you. The altar's open. Come. I'll lay my hands on you. Come up and pray. But anybody that's baptized in the Spirit has that ability to pray in the Spirit. And the other gifts should be working in your life. There should be power. The power of God should be operating in your life. So as they sing it again, if you want to be filled with the Spirit, if you need a fresh touch from God, come up. The altar's open. Is given to us as the power of God to help us fulfill your ministry and fulfill your calling. And every Christian should be filled with the Spirit. Someone say amen.
Amen. Amen.